So good afternoon. My name is Dorin. Some of you already we have met last Sunday or Sunday before. We're happy to see all of you and excited at the same time. The reason we are doing these classes, I must say I'm a vegetarian for many years. My wife as well, and the people who are going to present, they are vegetarians who are vegan. And we are going, during the recipes, we are going to give some guidelines, but I hope you can learn something today from this class. Those of you who didn't have a chance to come for two previous classes, we can give you the recipes, and you can have them, and we plan to have some classes after the new year, which I'm going to explain at the end, when we make some, when we give some information about future plans and projects as well. So, if you have any questions during the demo, you can ask. And today, I'd like to present. We have three chefs. We have yes, we have Vicky, Melina, and Julia. So, as you see in your recipe book. They are going to present different dishes, and hope you will enjoy. At the end, after it is presented, you'll have the chance to sample all of those recipes which are going to be presented. And I hope you'll enjoy. This is healthy. It's tasty, and we hope you'll like it. So I would like to invite Vicky. She's a great cook, and she will present the first recipe.
Slide up in here. Hello, everybody.
Good.
Hi.
Can you hear me? See me?
It's good.
Okay. So I have this, so that means serious business, right? Can you put this on? For today, we are going to make scallop potatoes. Who likes potatoes? Me too. I love potatoes. Scallop potatoes are usually done with eggs and milk, right? And we all really like them. Now, scallop potatoes are the best when they are really fresh, right? So we prepared some, so hopefully they will look good and taste good for you. So let's start with the recipe. It's very easy, very simple, and I think you will really make it. I haven't heard of one person that tried it and didn't like it. So you could be first. I don't know. We'll see. Okay, so what I have here, now it's not easy to cook with recipes either. Look at this. I gotta put this on too. Oh my goodness. I feel like I'm going to the moon. You know. Okay. It says 12 potatoes peeled and tightly sliced. So I got my potatoes here. I have to thank my sister-in-law. She was really nice. She helped me do all this stuff. So we have our potatoes in a bowl. We have two onions chopped. Where are the onions? It's in here. Now, with this recipe, nothing is engraved in the stone, okay? You don't like the onions, put onion powder, or don't omit, just don't use it, right? It's a basic thing that you need. So, we have, here is our onions. I can really smell the onions. And you can see I like lots of onions. If you don't like that much, use less, right? Then we have our carrots. I think that's the next. And they're grated. Now, some people like them even finely grated. I really don't mind. In my recipes at home, I even chop things big, and you know, I just love chewing them on the food. Okay, so we're going to put our salt. No. Sorry. Okay. I use sea salt. And so everybody has a different taste for the salt. Even when you taste your potatoes, you might need more salt, less salt, depends who likes what, right? So I'm gonna put some salt on, go to your taste. I think this is enough. See, this sea salt is, it's a very fine, it's really quite nice, but it's not really that salty, so you need to use a little more. I like to put a little bit of oil in this, and I use light olive oil. You can use sunflower oil, any oil that you use. I'm not particular about which way you go. Okay, again, you can actually omit the oil if you want. Just use very little. So I'll use a little bit. I should ask you to tell me when to stop. Maybe that would make it a little more easier, right? I know. So we are going to mix this over here. Will be nice, and we'll mix it with a spoon. At home, you do it by hand, then it's much nicer. Ah, it's okay. We'll do it this way. It doesn't have, because they are going to be baked, so we can just, as long as we toss them around. Okay, now this dish here, I'm going to use it here. If you have a deeper dish, it's much better because it really bubbles like a milk. So you don't want it out, right? So I was supposed to put just a little bit of this on the bottom. That has to be done. This. Like I said, use a deeper dish if you can. If it's too big of a recipe, just, you know, make less. If it's not enough, you know, just add more. So you can actually do whatever you like. In here, all I do is put the potatoes back in. See, I got too much for this dish, but anyway, we'll do it. Yeah, can I have that dish too? Because I make it in a bigger dish. And I think I had three more potatoes that were peeled, so I just put them in. You know. Oh, sorry, I need this. Actually, the thinner they are, the nicer and crispier they'll be at the end. That's okay. It's good. Okay, so now, this is what we do with potatoes. And this is the secret thing instead of eggs and milk, okay? We are going to use cashews. I have white cashews, just the regular cashews in here. I was nice to bring the whole cashews. You can buy, it's cheaper to buy pieces because you grind them up anyway, right? So you can get pieces. If somebody likes a little bit more nutty flavor, you can use roasted cashews, but this is healthier for you. So you can go either way. Okay, let's put this in. Okay, voila. Now, in the recipe, you have here, it says 3/4 cup of cashews, which that is, and 1 cup of water. Now, excuse me. What I like to tell you about cashews, anytime you mix the cashews, if you want them creamy, don't put too much water in, okay? So what we do is, if you have a cup of cashews, you will add a cup of water. As much cashews, that much water, okay? So I have 3/4 cup and I'll use 3/4 cup. You can do this very easily in your regular blender. You don't need these gadgets here, right? We do this just so it's faster, okay? That's it, this is how it works. Then we add the rest of the ingredients. And this is where you can be very versatile too. If you like some of the, oh, let me just put this here, sorry. Okay, so we need, should we go by recipe? Okay, water, so we need another one. Just a little bit more of water in here. Okay, we need garlic powder. You can put your fresh garlic in, it tastes really nice. I love garlic, I like onions, but if you don't, I have people in my family, some like garlic, some don't like. Some like onion, some don't like onion. Peppers, eggplant, same thing. So be versatile, okay? So I'm just gonna use some of this is chopped onion, garlic. You can use powder or you can use the other garlic in too. We have salt, oil, and the flour. Okay, so we'll use just a little bit of oil in here. In here you should put some oil. It makes it nice and creamy. So let's do this. just a little bit. Okay, salt. That's going. And that's about it, right? I would like to, we can use flour right away too. So, in here you have one teaspoon gluten-free flour. This time you are doing gluten-free, you can use any flour, like baking flour, any baking flour. Some people use cornstarch, or some people use,
oatmeal flour, yeah, or red bulb mill, all-purpose flour.
Yeah, just any, I just put a little bit. Sometimes I even forget to do this. If the potatoes are nice and fresh, they have their own, you know, sticky
starch.
Starch stuff. Okay, so this is that. Oh, click, didn't click. Okay, smart. Thank you.
See how nice and smooth it is in here? It's really nice and smooth. It's really good.
Until you get it nice and creamy, and it's really very easy to do that because it's in, and you'll see now when I pour it out. Okay, here we go, and I need my spatula. And we'll do this one here because those are my extra potatoes. Okay, oh, sorry, gotta move this out too. Okay, so as you can see, it's very nice and creamy. Just put that over.
Looks delicious already.
It smells good too. Okay, so I'm just gonna do this quickly. It doesn't take long to prepare and it's really, really tasty. So now, what I do, I add extra water. Can I have one more of water?
Sure.
Because your potatoes need to cook, right? You need to mix this through. Yeah, just put it in. Let's see. Yeah, I need a little more. I like to cover the potatoes, so with water. This is all you have to do with your potatoes. Just add it all. Yeah, it's good. If you have, if these are new potatoes, you don't need as much water because they are not going to soak too much. Springtime and they're older potatoes, you really need a little more, you know. I think this is enough. And all I do is cover this and I bake it. Now, I would like to ask one more thing. When you do your baking, you'll cover it with the foil. Don't cover it with foil only. Please use your baking sheet, you know, the wax paper or anything like that. And put that, and then put your aluminum over that. There are pieces of aluminum that can be found down when it's very hot, especially if it touches any oil. It actually, you can find pieces of aluminum at the end. So I would suggest that if you can, omit the, just using that. If you have the dishes that have the cover, that's even better, you know. So I would just bake it like this, covered. When it's almost done, I take it out and I just, you know, I let it just, get brown a little bit on top. Now, depends on your cashews, you are going to get a different look. So now, I was told I was supposed to clean this, but I didn't, so you can see how it looks when it's done. This is your, this is your finished product, okay? It's very easy, very simple, and very tasty. And it gives you, you have your potatoes. You have your cashews. It's a really good meal. You just salad, you need nothing else. Yes? Depends on your oven. This one I baked maybe 35 minutes, just till it's nice and soft. You know, you try it. As long as potatoes are done, everything else is finished. I do mine on 350, 375 to 400. I put it on 400 to start boiling and then I just take it down. But I think you know your oven, everybody knows kind of. I like the potatoes to start very fast, you know, and then you can tone it down to so. Any other questions? No? Good. Thank you. We'll try it later.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Melina, for those who are here first time. I was doing some heavy cooking last time, was I? And I hope that this time, too, you will enjoy it. We have excellent cooks here with us today, and unfortunately, we don't have our helper, Nada. She couldn't make it, but she texted me and she says, please say hi to everyone. She misses us. I told her we'll miss her too. But she says she's with us in spirit and hoping to get some goodies one day from us. Anyway, as you can see, I'm going to present to you today tofu cutlets. That is just my name for it. You know, we have scrambled tofu, we have tofu squares, tofu burgers, tofu this, tofu that, and I thought, okay, I'll call it tofu cutlets. And this particular dish is very easy, trust me. Okay, what we have here, we have step one, step two, step three, and bingo, you're done. So, what we'll do is, we'll use peppers. Now, for me to demonstrate here for you, I didn't use the full measurements. I used just the partial measurements. But at the back, we have another dish, which you will try, which is more than full measurement. So we have peppers. Then we have diced onions. Now, the onions, I diced here a little bit fine, but you don't have to dice it fine. You can just chop it. You know, the bigger the onion, sometimes the more flavor comes out. And I love onions in cooking. Then we have celery, carrots, mushrooms. We have crushed garlic. Can you pass me a spatula, please? Oh, here is one. Sorry. Thanks, Julia. Crushed garlic, and then we have coconut oil. I use coconut oil in this. I'm not sure whether it does give an extra sort of flavor or not, but I like cooking with coconut oil. I find that it is not rich, doesn't cause indigestion. It's easily digestible and ready available wherever we go. So I use some coconut oil, approximately a tablespoon. So, and with that, I use half a cup of water. So that when I say saute, you don't fry the vegetables, because burnt oil is not the best for you. So we just, is this on? Is it? Right. Can you plug that in too, please? Now that's step one. While that is cooking, we'll carry on with step two. We have here firm tofu. The one that I have in particularly that I like for this dish is soyogenic firm tofu, which is organic. It's very tasty in this dish, but you can use any tofu that you want, except if you use soft or medium firm, it goes a little bit crumbly. So you can use any brand you like. This one is available at Fortinos, Sobeys, or any other stores. So we have here tofu, which I cut up in cutlets. Mind you, I'm not very good at this. I don't have patience for things like this, to cut them up fine and perfect. That's why I never mind to be a chef. Okay, tofu. And then after tofu, we use Bragg's aminos. You know what Bragg's aminos are? Dr. Bragg is an American, or was, I should say, American gentleman who revolutionized the world that he lived in when he lived with natural products. And he traveled all over the world. In his time, I was living in New Zealand. And there was a club that used to be called Dr. Jensen's Club. And Dr. Jensen is also another American who is actually a doctor, who was, or is, he might be still alive, I'm not sure. And he used to come, and he organized, to New Zealand, he organized that club. He advocated natural foods, healthy living, and healthy lifestyle. And I was often called in to do cooking class together with them. And when Bragg used to come, Dr. Bragg used to come, we would have a wonderful time. They showed me how to grow sprouts. They taught me lots of things. But certain things I do not use, even that they promoted. However, here we'll have Bragg's aminos. It is a substitute for soya sauce. Soya sauce has a lot of sodium. This one hasn't got as much sodium. It can be pricey, but if you are happy with soya sauce that is naturally brewed, just like this one, you can use just the same. Hello and welcome. Then we have turmeric. And we have garlic powder. As you can see, I don't measure things. I just throw them together and hope for the best. But it's good to have the measurements to give you, yes. And like Vicky said, these recipes are so basic that you can omit something or add something that will still keep the same flavor and the same nutrition. So, we keep cooking this. For a little while, just to make sure that all the flavors are absorbed. Can I have this space? Delete. We'll put the lid on that one. And you can see here, I don't know whether you can. Can you show on the wall somehow?
Yes, it is.
You can see here, good, thanks, how it is being done. So, in order to save time, I'm not going to cook it till the end. I'll pretend once again like I did last week. Do you know that last week I did this cooking class without stoves, without frying pans? Amazing, isn't that? And yet the food was cooked. That was a miracle work. Okay, so we will mix the arrowroot. Arrowroot, do you know what it is? It's, anybody wants to know? Right, arrowroot is excellent starch or excellent type of thickener. You can use instead of cornstarch. The process of cornstarch to get it to what it is not the healthiest. So the arrowroot takes the place of cornstarch. And it is a plant. It is used in many, in baking and cooking, and particularly in stews and sauces. So what we'll do is mix a little bit of arrowroot to give that bit of glaze or a bit of thickness to make it saucy-like. And then what we do, we combine the both dishes together. Now, if I was doing this at home, I might cook it just a little bit longer to get it a little bit softer. But because we are rushed here for time, thanks, Julia, I just do it very quickly. Now, who is here? Is Rita here? Or Ivanka? Would you please come over? Thank you. I just spotted my friend. Last time I heard Julia showing, would you like just to tag this? It's the way you go, that's okay. Oh, what's that? Yeah, just tag these around to show people what it looks like. Sometimes in the picture you can't convey the true look of things. So,
need a smell, huh?
And what I do is when I cook it, put it in a serving dish, then I just sprinkle some parsley. Now, anyone has a question about this? Very simple, straightforward. I think I have mentioned last time, when I married my husband, he was asking me, well, before I married, you know, can you cook? And I said, yeah, I think so. So I made a dish, I can't remember what type of a dish it was. He says, very simple. Good. I said, well, I'm a simple person, I can't cook anything else, it's a simple food. And were you able to? But you see, I was fortunate there. My mother-in-law at that time was not a vegetarian, and my husband was. So she more or less wanted to learn from me how to cook vegetarian food, and I had to make an effort. And from then on, I started loving cooking. And to this day, I still love cooking, and I am so happy to be able to share it with you. Any other questions? No? Well, if we don't have any more questions on this dish, we have, in the kitchen, please. We have on our program, next dish, anybody knows?
The buffalo is next.
The next one, we have waffles. The tomato, or tomato, I should say, tomato, we say it in New Zealand. A tomato and sprout dish is a very simple dish. You know, you just arrange it to look attractive, and there's nothing to it except sliced tomatoes. Maybe we can bring the dish out. Tomato dish, please. Just sliced tomatoes with sprouts on top, alfalfa sprouts on top, and you can sprinkle some oil on it, a little bit of salt if you want it, or kelp, or whatever you prefer, just a simple tomato dish. Because you have strong flavor in your scalloped potatoes, you have strong flavor in your tofu cutlets, and you want something that is mild and simple to go with that. And this is what we have. Okay, next one is our waffles with berry sauce. Now, who loves to eat waffles? I don't know about you, but sometimes they show on me. The moment I have one only, it still shows immediately. Now, this recipe was given to me by my sister-in-law from the United States. And I have altered it to somehow to such an extent that she says, I can't recognize that recipe anymore. So this is what we have. For this, again, it's very simple. Can we have the waffle machine? Usually, what you do, you go to a store and you buy the best quality waffle mix. And you bake waffles. You might add water and eggs and you make waffles or pancake or whatever it is. But this one is different. With this one, I have, as you can see, I'll just turn my waffle machine on. I have 4 cups of water. These blenders are so wonderful because they are big enough. Everything can go in, but you can cut the recipe in half or quarter it or whatever. Then we have, can I have the almonds first, please? Then we have some almonds. You can have chopped almonds or half almonds. I just put a whole almonds in. Then we have some sweet frozen corn. Now, this one's not frozen anymore, but if you have fresh sweet corn on the cob, just cut the cob and you get a corn kernel. And that's what is that you need. Then we have some 3 tablespoons of sunflower oil. I use sunflower. That's just my preference. It's a personal preference, but you can use whichever you like. And then I use here oatmeal flour, which is gluten-free again. All our recipes today are gluten-free. And sea salt. I put a sea salt underneath. So just a teaspoon of sea salt. And then we have 4 cups of rolled oats. And again, I use these red bulb mills rolled oats, which is, it's not guaranteed, but they reckon his oats are less or almost no gluten whatsoever. So for those who are gluten allergic, they can use them. And this is all we do. We'll just bring this a little bit closer. Put the lid on. Oh, may I have the top for the lid? Where is it? Here. Good. Okay. Excuse the noise. After it's mixed, now don't mix it too fine, because if it's too fine, you get waffles a little bit soggy. But after it's mixed, you wait for a few minutes before cooking. And I have to wait a few minutes for my waffle pan to get warm. And usually, if you take half a cup or a quarter of a cup, but if you are like me, you don't want to have too much washing, you just pour it directly from the jug. We'll just wait a little bit longer. It's still heating. In the meantime, are there any questions about this? Red Bob Mills.
B-O-B?
B-O-B, yes. You'll have to excuse my accent. I've lived in this country for a long time, and I lived in New Zealand for a long time, but I still can't lose these Serbian or Yugoslavian, or whatever you like to call accent. Anyway.
What's the quarter on your way to mixing your waffle?
Say it again?
Yeah.
Thank you. Sometimes it's good to spray your waffle pan. I use coconut oil, Pam's coconut oil, which is very inexpensive, and it's really good to do that. Oh, we are taking time. Should I put this on? You see, I'm not very well organized, am I? Now, if I had a boss, he would sack me. I just wanted to say that during these 3 weeks, the last 3 weeks, I have enjoyed being here in this lovely town of yours and meeting you all and sharing with you what we all like to do. And I hope that you too have enjoyed our visit into your town. And if in the future we find that there is a greater interest or same interest, we will come again. Otherwise, with your permission, we can let you know when we have it in some other place. And if you want to drive a little bit further, you're welcome to come. Our classes are aimed for a healthier community so that people enjoy health and still enjoy the foods that they eat. Because we cannot derive the nutrients from the foods that we have unless we enjoy it. And there is a saying that heaven loves the man who eats well. I think I eat well, I hope. I must be loved. But food is not all. There's much more to it. We need divine power in order to enjoy good health. And we need to have faith, trust, and hope in God. With good food, with such attributes of character, we'll get a long way. My late mother became vegetarian 8 years before I was born. At that particular time, she suffered from tuberculosis, and she was also expecting my brother. The doctors wanted her to terminate her pregnancy. They wanted to treat her, but she would not. She was a Christian lady, and she says, "I cannot do what you require me to do. If I must die, I must die with clear conscience." However, she didn't die. She lived to be 90 years of age. And that particular brother of mine is close to 80 years of age, is still alive. So it just shows, during those months and years, she turned to natural medicine, to a lot of raw foods. She gave up alcohol, she gave up tea and coffee, she gave up all the meats, red, white, whatever, she gave it all up for the sake of her own health and the health of her child, actually for the sake of her own life and the life of her child. And she stayed that way, and that is how I was brought up, on a vegetarian diet. And I remember when I was a child, I mentioned here, I didn't like to eat certain things, particularly dish I demonstrated here last time. I didn't like to eat spinach. I didn't like to eat peas. But with my mother's persistence and insistence, with patient guidance, I learned to eat those foods and enjoy them. And today, I enjoy them. My children enjoy them. My grandchildren enjoy them. And my son-in-law enjoys them too. And it is one of the greatest blessings that I believe I have, being brought up in a household with a mother who has been health conscious. Well, let's try now to put our waffles in. We won't cook too many here. I'll just fry a little bit. And for those of you who like sesame, I'm just going to use a little bit of sesame. And just sprinkle a bit onto the pan directly. more or less. Sesame, these sesame seeds are hulled, so they're nice. But you don't have to do this if you don't like sesame. Some people who have dentures find sesame gets stuck underneath the dentures, and therefore they don't like to use it. Well, here we are. Our waffle mix is just lovely, ready to use. Oh, I made a mess. I'm a messy child. Don't do like that at home. At home I do it worse. I'm being careful here. Just watch me. Now I'm going to put too much and it's going to pour all over the place. I tend to do that. Now, may I have that? Yes. Here it is. And then we close this and we give it a time. It will beep at me 5 minutes. But in 5 minutes you check it. If you think you want it a little bit darker, just cook it a little longer. And when we finish with our waffles, when they are done, everyone likes to have maple syrup on their waffles, is that so? Have you tried fresh fruit? Yes. There are a variety of things that we can try to put on our waffles, you know, coconut cream, whipped up coconut cream or fresh cream. But here I have decided to show you a very quick and easy recipe. We have mixed berries. This were frozen, but now they're not. Then we have some pineapple juice. You can use either pineapple or grape or orange, whichever juice you want, apple, whichever juice you have on hand. And all you have to do is bring it to boil. And while we're waiting for that to bring to boil, you mix in a little bit of arrowroot with water and pour in to give it that nice sort of saucy texture. Let's pretend this boiled, okay? And you pour it in, mix it again. May I have a mix, something to mix it with? We'll use this. And that's all it is. Now, when you pour in your arrowroot starch or flour, just wait till it gets translucent so that your sauce doesn't look whitish or anything like that. See this, don't wait, don't have it like that. Have it to look nice and clear. Now, the berries that we have here are blackberries, blueberries, and strawberries and raspberries. But you can use any fruit. You know, pineapple is very nice, you know, crushed pineapple. We had here last time, crushed pineapple on top of our, coconut pudding. Well, you can use crushed pineapple on top of your waffles. You can use, of course, maple syrup, or you can make your own sauce. Just use your imagination. You know, with vegetarianism, imagination acts a very important part. Yes, you can eat cabbage and carrot and lettuce and tomatoes and so on, but you need to make it appetizing. You need to make it inviting. You need to make it tasty. And some people don't like the foods that are not tasty, particularly if they're not vegetarians. They like meat, and why? Meat on its own has no flavor, no taste. Meat is tasty because you add salt and fat and you add other things, and that's what it gives the taste. And the same is with other vegetables. Sometimes it's good to taste just the vegetable as is. But other times it's nice to give it a flavoring. Another minute or so, and our sauce will be ready, as well as our waffles. Any questions on these? No questions? Hurry up, we want to taste it, eh? Yes. Well, while we're waiting on that, our next on list is Nutella. And we will let Julia, she's our one of our youngest cooks, a very good cook, and a lovely young lady. She will show you how to make homemade Nutella, which is very tasty. When she made it this morning, I tasted and I thought, oh my dear, I want more. So, but she didn't let me have it. So we'll let Julia now show you how to make Nutella. And I will take this out of your way.
And I would like to present to you a very nice recipe. It's a very easy recipe and something sweet and you can do for your children. And it's sugar-free and it's cocoa-free and it's very, very tasty. And we're gonna start with our first ingredient is going to be a hazelnut. You can buy a raw hazelnut and then you can just bake them, roast them in your oven. You preheat your oven for about 35 Fahrenheit and just roast them for about 10-15 minutes. And just make sure don't go anywhere while you're roasting your hazelnut because it's very easy to burn them. You need to make sure that you're looking at them and just try to mix them and you will see the skin start coming like popping off and you will see that it's ready. And don't overdo it because it's going to be bitter. And then you're gonna take, actually some of my friends said, you know what, just buy a roasted hazelnut. It's much easier and I agree and I never buy, but you can also buy a roasted hazelnut and it's going to be less work for you. And then you're gonna take your roasted hazelnut. It's about one cup and a half, and it's about this quantity. I use so many blenders, and in this recipe, it's my old recipe, and I didn't have so powerful blender, and I use it through the coffee grinder to make them nice and smaller pieces, and then you just put in a blender. And also if you use a ninja blender, you need to first to put hazelnut, blend in them, and then start adding other ingredients. But this one is actually very good, and you don't need to do that. It's a Vitamix, and you just put everything inside and just blend it. Here we have hazelnuts, and then I'm gonna take my carob. That's one of the things, who knows what is a carob? Can I see the hands? Who knows what is a carob? Yeah, oops. Carob, it's what I use instead of cocoa powder. You can find in the stores almost everywhere. It tastes very good, and I take a toasted carob. You can take a regular carob, but the toasted carob is better taste, and in Nutella is just amazing. And I buy carob powder like that, and in the recipe you can see it's about 5 to 6 tablespoons of carob powder, but I'm gonna recommend you to start from 4 to 5 tablespoons, and then you will see if you can handle this taste, and if you like this taste, add more. But just make a note in your paper that you need to start from 4 to 5 tablespoons of carob powder. You're gonna add a carob powder in there, and then we'll go to our coconut oil. The coconut oil, I prefer to use organic, and as many of you know, it's modified, and it's better to buy organic coconut oil, and it's very healthy for many different things, for many different dishes, and even on your body too. And I prefer to have organic coconut oil. And you're gonna take and you're gonna put, you know what, it comes actually very hard, and because it's solid. And you know what, while I was roasting my hazelnuts, I just put in that oven, I turned off the oven, and I let the door a little bit open and just put a little bit of that coconut oil, like it, because it's very solid. Just put inside and it's going to be melted. And I have kind of melted, but in the kitchen it's still warm and it's not so hard anymore. And we're gonna put it in there, everything. And then our next ingredients is agave syrup, if I'm right.
Agave.
Sorry, that's my mistake. I always confuse this name, agave syrup. Everybody knows I have organic agave syrup, and I tried this recipe with honey. It's too sweet. I tried this recipe I can't remember now the name of that. It's too sweet, but agave syrup is very good. It's not so sweet. And you know what? I have here this amount of agave syrup, but you can measure. If you like more, just add more. If you like less, add less. And I have here, and I'm gonna put it in there too, everything in this powerful water mix. It's very strong. Yes, I was just thinking about that. Sister Milena,
yes.
Your waffles? Oh, they're good.
Oh, they're good.
They're fine.
They're fine.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. This machine works good.
It's just
salt
itself.
Oh, that's good.
Very
sure.
Good.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
And then I use my, as you can see, almond milk. I prefer to buy unsweetened almond milk. It's better, and it doesn't have so many sugar in it. And I prefer this kind of, and it doesn't have, this word. I remember, I forget. It's my favorite, and I will recommend to you. There is no sugar added, and no carbohydrates. Yes, that's right, something like that's right. And I really like to use that. And you can see on the recipe, you don't need to add everything at once. You're gonna add more than half, and you're gonna blend it. And you will see if you need more or less. And why you put coconut oil? Because after we finish that Nutella, we're gonna put in the fridge and refrigerate that. And after that, it came very smooth, like a creamy. And that's why I put coconut oil and milk. It gives the same things, very creamy texture. Okay, and I'm gonna start using that. It's going to be a little bit loud. And we're gonna add a little bit more. As you can blend, very nice and smooth. I'm sorry, they're all here and now I can't see anyone. And it's, you know what, as Nutella, you can see it's very smooth. When you buy Nutella, like original Nutella, it's very smooth. And I would like to have this smooth taste. And actually when you do, from the warm roasted hazelnut, when you open that lid, it smells amazing. It smells just amazing with the roasted hazelnut. It's just so good. And when you do that, and you'll try, it tastes amazing, smells so good. And I know my children, they like that, and my family like that, and it's very sweet, and it tastes a little bit different, just a little bit different, but almost like Nutella. And you can put on your bread, on your waffles, and everywhere. We like. Okay. And you can see in that in this Vitamix, it came very smooth, very, very, very smooth. And it's, if you would like to add more milk, you're free to add. And if you put in your fridge, it's going to be so hard and smooth and nice. But I would prefer to leave it like that. And then we're just going to take our spatula and we're going to put in our dish. And you can see, it's for the children, they'll not realize it's something different. And just remember, here is no sugar at all. No sugar and no cocoa powder. And I will ask my husband to talk more about carob. Why carob? Why is not cocoa powder? I know it's healthier and you can see many better benefits of using carob powder. And that's the recipe of homemade Nutella, a healthy homemade Nutella. Thank you so much. And our next recipe is fruit bonbon. Sister Milena?
Okay, what do we have left? We have fruit bonbons. When I say bonbons, what do you visualize?
Candy.
Candy. Would you like something better than candy?
Yes.
Okay, these are candies, all right, real big ones. I'm going to, just show you my candies. See these ones? These are the best candies you can give your children. The best candies, well, you can't buy them anyway. You have to make them. And I'm not going to make them for you today because we are running out of time. Besides, it's a messy job. I need another machine here and another mixer and something else. And I need extruder and so on. So I'm not going to demonstrate, but I'm going to talk about it. These type of candies have the fruited type listed here. But you know what? You can have half of it. You can take some out, add something else, and so on. And then what you do, you mince the fruit. Don't mince it too fine, because if you mince it too fine, then when you eat it, it's sort of not chewy enough. You want it to be chewy. And when you minced it, when you added all the ingredients to make it easy to handle, you can put the gloves on like I usually do. Put the gloves on because it gets into your hands and you don't want it. And make them into balls. You know something? You might be better than me. Again, I'm saying I haven't got enough patience to make them exactly the same. You can make them much smaller. But Doreen and I made these this morning, and we were just hurrying, so let it done, let's get it done. And this is the sizes we made. They are very tasty, according to everyone else that tried them. I like them. If you have a sweet tooth and you want guiltless candy, this is it. It's very handy. When my children were young, I used to make this for their school lunches. And their friends at school would say, did you bring some candy? Did you bring bonbons in? So they loved them. And one of their friends, by the name of Peter, come from the same old country where I came from, former Yugoslavia. And he was being brought up in a family that eat lots of meat and potatoes and bread and, you know, most Serbians or Croatians or former Yugoslavs, they do that, eat rich food. And he stopped eating meat because when he would come to our house, he would see what we eat and he would go home. He says, I don't want that, I don't want that. his mother says, my Peter is going through a very difficult stage in his young life. He doesn't want to eat meat. I'm hoping he'll grow out of it. But you know what? Peter never grew out of it. Peter grew up. Peter finished his degree. Peter eventually became an entrepreneur. He opened a health food store and a healthy lunch bar. And he got, somehow he met one of my daughters and he says, tell your mom, she'll be proud of me. I am still vegan, not just vegetarian, vegan. And he says, my lunch bar is doing very well. This is in New Zealand. And I was so impressed that that young man, he was only a young child, young boy in a high school, even in primary school, he would be, you know, my children. And he stuck to his diet. So there is that factor that you have to love what you eat. And so today I hope you will love what we have prepared for you and finish off with nice candy, bonbons. But before we start that, we're going to ask for a blessing of the food. This is our custom, this is our habit, and I hope you don't mind that we are going to do it again. So we'll ask Spencer, he did it such a great job last time. Would you please do it again, Spencer?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
No
Thanks.
Problem. Our dear Heavenly Father, we are humbled and grateful to be joined here today with this wonderful Vegetarian Way cooking class. We're grateful for the knowledge that we've learned and the sacrifices of those who have shown us how to do so and the wonderful hands that have prepared the food for us to enjoy. We ask it to bless it, that it will nourish our bodies, and that we will take what we've learned into our lives and strive to live happily and with proper nutrition for us and our families. And we thank you, Father, for these things. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen. Well, I want to thank you all for coming. Thank you. And I want to thank our cooks who have demonstrated today.